Welcome to the Dask setup documentation. Dask can be deployed in a variety of ways, including just a local thread pool, various processes on one machine, or various processes spread across a cluster of machines. It can be deployed manually using a variety of command line interfaces, or using some automated tooling that's maintained by the Dask community. In this screencast, we're going to talk first about how to use Dask in a very simple way, then we'll increasingly become more complex if we deploy it on larger machines. So let's first start out with the simplest possible situation. We have a Python user who doesn't know much about setting things up. They just want to use Dask as a normal library, the same way that they would Python or NumPy or Pandas. So I might import, say, Dask array or Dask DataFrame. I might construct some array, and I'll go ahead and do some computation. Notice I haven't done any setup here, but I'm still running this in parallel. Notice here I'm using 700% of my CPU. Let's run that again just to be sure. So I haven't done any setup, I haven't talked to IT or any cluster administrators, and I'm still using, looks like, 7 or 8 cores on my laptop. So that's pretty effective. Now, if you want to go beyond that, if you want to go out to many processes on one machine or many processes across a cluster, it does require a little bit more work. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So Dask is a centrally managed distributed computing platform. That means that there's one process which runs the Dask scheduler command. This is tracking all of the workers that you have. Now, on a variety of other machines, you can run the Dask worker command, giving it the address of your scheduler process. In this case, it's just localhost. I'm just on one machine. But if I wanted to, this could be on different machines as well. And we see that as I connect different workers, they phone home with the scheduler, and we register new workers to the scheduler. Now, my Python user, now remember they had this computation from before. We're not going to run it just yet. First, we're going to connect up to that same scheduler. Copy and paste failure there. We're going to copy the same address. Now that I've attached a client to that scheduler, all of my Dask computations will run across those different workers. So now I'm using these two processes to do my work. If I were to add a new process, that process would also start participating in that work and would start accelerating my computation. Dask workers can come and go from the cluster as we please. So this is now a new worker, or I can destroy that worker, and Dask will be just fine. So in principle, all we need to do to set up Dask is start up a scheduler on one machine and workers on many others. There are a variety of tools that help you do this, and you may be coming to this document from this page. It is on docs.dask.org at the setup page. So we've just seen how Dask works with the command line, and that just goes over what we've just seen. There are a variety of other technologies, like Yarn for Hadoop or Spark clusters, various cloud technologies like Kubernetes, or various high-performance job schedulers like SGE, Slurm, PBS, LSF, Torque, or others. All these do is just set up schedulers and workers for you, but they provide Python users a nice interface for doing so. We're going to see how the interface looks like just with a local cluster. So I'm going to close down my workers and scheduler here. I'm going to set up all of those automatically from Python. So I need my client and a local cluster object. So I'm going to make my cluster. And I might provide arguments here like threads per worker, or number of processes or amount of memory to use, but I'm just going to use the defaults. Then I'm going to make a client, and instead of giving it the address of that scheduler, I'm just going to give it the cluster itself. And this cluster has a scheduler that it has started for us, and also a bunch of workers. So it has done that process that we did on the command line, but it did it for us automatically. Now that client is connected up, and it can see all of those workers nicely. Now let's say I want to switch from not using a local cluster, but let's say I want to use a supercomputing cluster. So I might use the Dask job queue package, which has various projects like, let's say, PBS cluster. And instead of making a local cluster, I'll instead use PBS cluster. Now I might need to add more keyword arguments. I expect if I run this, it will fail. And it's going to tell me the kinds of things I need to add here. But the workflow is the same. I'm going to provide a variety of interesting keyword arguments that telling Dask how to interact with my cluster. Then I'm going to create a client around that cluster. And that cluster will handle creating schedulers and workers for us. So these are the basics of how to set up Dask. Again, if you want to go very low tech, all you have to do is set up workers on a variety of machines and point them to some central scheduler. However, a lot of the work has already been done for you. If you're interested, I recommend that you look at some of these other technologies. A lot of work is here, and it's usually very easy to do this kind of work. So that's it. Thanks for your time. Again, you should go to docs.dask.org, and there's plenty of interesting information here around the way in which you probably just deploy workers yourself.